All right. Now, finally, officially live on air, Hot Dog Vendor Radio and Street Food Vendor TV. Thank you for joining us. We've been having a blast on the pre-show. I never really do pre-shows, but I was having fun talking to people, answering questions, just chit-chatting, mostly just BSing. And we're supposed to have a couple guests tonight, should have a couple guests. Don't know who all's going to show up, who isn't going to show up. It's a holiday weekend, and a lot of times that slows us down. Last week, or last month, on the first Sunday of the month, we had a very small crowd, the smallest crowd I'd had in years. I don't know why. I could have done it at a, you know, during a funeral and had better results, but it was a small crowd. The next day, no, it wasn't the next day. 2 days later, there was like 5,400 downloads of the show. So it was like the people missed it and then they downloaded it. So I don't know what caused last first Sunday of the month to be dead on here, but it was pretty stale. I think we had less than 50 people. If it says you're muted, it automatically go to webinar automatically mutes anybody that joins in. So that is why you're probably muted. If you would like to ask a question, there is a hand raise thing where I can open up your mic and you can join me, or you can type in a question. So you can do it either way you want. It's up to you. And we're still adding people. It's like going because it's 9:02 and everybody's showing up. Okay, so we are live though, and keep that in mind when you come on. Be courteous, kind, and sweet, and all that good stuff. We've really only had a problem twice in about 7 years. Mike says hi. Hey, Mike. Somebody says that's a bigger number than the amount of people that watch MSN. Oh, cool. Mike says he just got his pump and heater for his concession trailer he's building. Oh, that's retro vending. Retro vending. Yeah. Anyway, we have a great show. We've got free stuff only you'll get offered. Haha, because you're here. And also, I don't know if you remember this. Let me show you something. For those listening in, you can't see this, but you'll remember it. And there's been pictures on Facebook. Do you remember this? That shirt? Let me tell you the story of that shirt. I have given that shirt away 3 times, the same stupid shirt. Okay? Now, we just gave away the caulk gun thing that went out, and he's going to send pictures for us to look at. But that shirt. This is months now, okay? I just got it back off the second person. The third person never sent the email. Never sent the email. The f second person, wrong address. So out of 3 people, only one address was, you know, all you have to do is email me with your address and I mail it to you. That's simple, right? And actually, it's my daughter. She'll mail it to you. And it's pretty easy. But I have the shirt. And so tonight, I'm going to try it again. So if you're here during this show listening live, somebody's going to freaking win this shirt. And it's a cool shirt. Look at this. For you listening in that can't see, just take my word for it. It's freaking awesome. Now, it is extra large, but it is sexy. It's a hot dog on a shirt all the way, fully engulfed in hot dog goodness. So that's gonna go. We've got other stuff too. Let's see here. Retro vending's here. Wendy says, condiment squisher thing. Oh, Mike, your condiment squisher thing went out. Okay? It went out, but it went out delayed because I use a fulfillment company, so I had to get it to them. I next date it to them, and they get it to you. Okay, it's blah. Okay, that's just the way it works. So, I'm under it. I'll explain that later. Anyway, it's coming. It's in the mail. It's on the way to you. My guess is you'll have it Monday or Tuesday, maybe Wednesday, latest. Okay, so Mike won the Mike at Retro Vending won the condiment the caulk gun. That's a sexy gun. Where do you see it? Let's see here. Now, Let's get to some other stuff. We have, if you have a question, throw it in there and I'll try to get to everybody's questions as I go. I'm doing this all alone tonight. Jason's supposed to be here tonight. And I'm not sure where he is yet, but he may have forgotten, or he may not be feeling good. You remember Jason had surgery, and so I'm not sure. I did talk to him this morning. So that's where we are. Now, we've got some people with their hands up. Now, this thing tells me when you have your hands up that you want to join me live. So I'm gonna, well, one, I already know. Matt with bow ties and hot dogs out of Knoxville, Tennessee. You're live, brother, and then I'll bring on some other people, but let's catch up with you. Can you hear me?
Yeah, how you doing? You got me?
Can you hear me?
I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you just barely.
Let me adjust here. Somebody was messing with my board.
Is everybody else having trouble hearing Matt? Yeah, they say they can't hear you.
About now?
Oh yeah, that's way good.
Looks like the kid's been playing with the soundboard. So.
Oh yeah.
Well, it's been a good week. It's been a good month, I guess. This month went by fast. At least the weather really sucked. This has been the hottest summer, I swear. But at least people came out and everything. So.
Good, good. What have you done new, different, unique? What's going on? Give us some updates on, and there's always new people here, and I know you may get tired of saying it because you come on every time. Give us the short rundown of how long you've been vending and what you've learned in this short little time. How far you've gone in this short little time.
Well, that did happen, actually. We hit our 1 year. We had our 1 year anniversary at the beginning of August. So that was nice to see on Facebook. A lot of memories. So we've been doing a year. We went full time in March. A year of actual vending. But we do our whole theme is bow ties and hot dogs. Little retro, playing Frank Sinatra music and everything while we're out there. Bow ties and newsboy hats. I got a new hat. I got a fedora this week. This past week. So I was a little excited about that. Upgrading the wardrobe a little.
Is he gonna, are you having to change the name to Fedora? Hot
No,
dog?
fedora, bow ties, and hot dogs. Indiana Jones dogs, you know.
There you
But
go. There you go.
man, I made a new dog that I was just stoked about, and it is the Hawaiian one, and that thing is just, people are asking about it. We were in the store, and I just thought it up, but I took Spam, grilled it on the grill there, and in a third pan, I had teriyaki sauce reducing, so then I took the Spam and tossed it in the thickening teriyaki sauce, then I put that on the bun, and then the hot dog, my quarter pound Nathan's. And then I made a Asian slaw with red cabbage, Napa cabbage, carrots, cilantro, caraway seed, garlic, and then some teriyaki and sesame dressings mixed in, and then pineapple on top. You can see that at the Bow Ties and Hot Dogs Facebook. People love that one, but it's pretty interesting, especially getting a use out of Spam. But that's been a good month. We've got a block party tomorrow, so that should be fun. We had a real successful lemonade day doing another block party. Sold out, got to go home early.
Tell us what the block party is.
Well, getting involved with neighborhood communities, here in Knoxville, or any city, you have your sub-communities. Like tomorrow I'm doing a Sequoia Hills block party, which is a real big neighborhood in Knoxville, but it's kind of a upscale historical neighborhood. We got asked out to do that, and once again it was vegans that came through for me, because the lady who organized it's a vegan and had one of my vegan frankfurters, and so she asked us to come out and do that because last year They had one person out, and they just got flooded and couldn't keep up. So hopefully we have that same problem tomorrow. And then another one I did just lemonade because they called me, and they said, they're doing this block party, but they already had, I think, five food vendors. So I said, well, I'll just do lemonade if that's okay. And, we sold out of lemon. I was out of lemons, so we had a couple cases of lemons, so it was a good day.
That is a good day.
Oh, yeah, and especially not having to clean a cart or anything and making the same money, so definitely a good thing. And the only new thing I've been researching real heavy cold brew coffee right now. I've been watching every YouTube video possible on it. So hopefully I'll roll that out before the next month or so. I'd like to try that out. So, but that's been about it, you know. Jet's back in school, so I'm training my 4-year-old now to be my Coke guy. So he was out the other day. He's doing a good job. So sometimes he gets confused between Coke and Diet Coke, but he's out there doing a good job.
Will little man still help you on the weekends?
Yeah, he likes to still help out on Saturdays and stuff. I usually take Sundays off. So, and tonight I actually have the first night in a year where my baby, our youngest child, is not here tonight. So we went downtown. We just got back from downtown Knoxville and had a nice dinner down there at Knoxville 5 or 5 Knoxville, whatever it's called. So it was a good day, good month. And now the temperature's finally dropping. So. Can't wait for fall.
I have put up a link to bow ties and hot dogs, so you can follow on Facebook. It'll help you get ideas. We all share ideas and stuff, and I'm sure that Matt would love to have you follow him and look at what he's doing, how he's marketing the pictures he takes. Gorgeous pictures, and they always look good. Also, I'm going to throw up Retro Vendings link as well, so take a look at it and follow these vendors. Follow Love, Food Truck Company. Follow O'Doggies. These guys, you'll come out ahead because you'll pick up little things, and even if you don't pick up something from them, you're going to be inspired. You know, like that Hawaiian dog may inspire something in you. You said you came up with the Hawaiian dog on what, on a whim? You said you were where?
I was at Walmart, and I think I saw a pineapple, and I was like, you know, how can I use a pineapple? So.
See how it works? So, and somebody asked, this just, it doesn't even say a name, which is odd. They put in for their name friend. Does he fresh squeeze his lemons?
Yeah, absolutely. Warren Russell, and I'm just going to toss his name out there because he's one of the best guys in lemonade out there. But he's just now starting to do kind of what I do, which is he's calling them his naturals, which he uses all real fruit and everything. I don't use any of the syrups or anything like that. The only syrup I use is just simple syrup, which is just pure sugar and water. I get a 96-count lemon, which is one of the biggest lemons you can get, and that way it's 1-to-1. Yep. I don't have to worry about too little lemon or anything. That up, you know, about into 6 pieces or so. And then I've got a pneumatic press. So I like to use that set on about 110 PSI. And the sound and everything attracts people. It makes it very interesting. You get these shaking cups. They're 32-ounce. You put the lemons in there, you smash them, squeeze them, however you do. You can get a manual press too. Then you put your simple syrup in, whatever your recipe calls for. Ice, water, shake it up, pour it in a cup. I mean, you're done in like 35 seconds. Charge $3 to $5, whatever you want. I mean, and it's gold. I mean, it's definitely something you can add to carts. I know there's several. I think Retro is doing it at his cart on a daily basis. And there's a couple carts doing it. I need to really get that out on a daily. But I want to get it set up on CO2 so it's easier to transport and everything because I'm tired of dealing with air compressors and such.
That lemonade, I don't know if you remember, I did it live twice and filmed live while we did it after Jason taught us that 3 or 4 years ago. the lemon squisher thing, and I set up a table, and I did it, and we did several thousand dollars in a weekend, and I filmed it so that people could see it and see what I was doing, and I was charging $5 a cup. And now it was the big cup, but a 32-ounce cup, once you put ice in it, you put half the lemon in it, and I was using the big lemons like you, and I was using the simple syrup, you know, I had made sugar water, and then just adding the regular water and shake it up. There wasn't that much. I mean, you might have 12 ounces of actual liquid in there, and maybe 16 max, and it was kicking butt.
Yeah, you've got show number 123, which was last year. I think pretty much this time last year you did If Life Give. It's called Life If Give, Life Gives You Lemons. So
yeah, I redid the article on it. The old one is probably 3 or 4 years ago. But if you just type in lemon on the search on the blog, the first lemon, the oldest lemon one down the page will be that article where Jason gives his recipe for the simple syrup. Now, you're not using simple syrup, though, right?
I use my own simple syrup, but when it comes to strawberries, like I'll sell strawberry lemonade for $2 extra, but I cut up 2 fresh strawberries, put them in there, and it just is awesome, especially when you smash them or when I do raspberries, blueberries. And so I don't use like a strawberry syrup or a blue syrup. I literally use fresh fruit. And I do lemons and limes. People love the limeade. Now, for limeade, you can make a cherry limeade. You add, like, some cherries in there, too. And, I mean, it's just real easy. I mean, you can charge $2 extra for 2 strawberries. You can get 2 pounds of strawberries from your produce company for $6, you know, so.
Somebody asked, is that the same lemonade as, this is Cassie. Cassie said, is this the same lemonade as a lemonade shake-up?
Yeah, essentially that's a shake-up recipe, yeah. But there's different ways you can make. I mean, that's what you do. You shake them. It super cools it, so it's so cold. You know, that's the whole shaking process. You know, so it's a real simple recipe, and you know, it's something great to diversify, because I mean, you want to make as much money. You know, if you're out there for 5 hours or whatever, you want to make as much money, and you want to have options. Like I said, you know, they called me and said, "Hey, do you want to do this block party?" And they told me there's 5 food vendors. It's like, well, yeah, I want to be part of it, but I don't think I'm gonna make that much money if there's already 5. You know, vendors, but hey, let me do drinks, and I'll take all the lion's share of that, and I did.
Dorothy, let me just cut you, because I keep getting messages, and so I have to stay up with them, but Dorothy just sent in, somebody had mentioned coffee, and Dorothy sent in a link to a Facebook page I'm going to post up for everybody that is supposed to be the best, the best recipe. It says the best recipe for cold brew coffee that she has found. Cold brew coffee. Go ahead, Matt. I'm sorry.
Oh, I was going to say, you know, Cubish here in Knoxville, they did something. They did a lemonade event for the Harry Potter thing. And what they did was they ended up putting, depending what house people wanted to be in, I guess, they put like different glow sticks inside the lemonade too. So it would be red or blue or green or something like that. It's pretty cool. So there's a lot of cool things you can do with that. And thank you for that recipe there. Because definitely, like I said, cold brew coffee, it's a real hot trend, and it's so easy to do. You know, you don't have to have a brew station on your cart.
Right.
You know, it's already brewed.
He's been doing it real well.
Yeah, well, he's got a cool setup, though, for it. He's got like a real... is he doing it nitrogen pressed or something like that, or...
Yeah.
So he's doing it, but you don't have to have that. You know, you can literally, you know, take your grounds and just, you know, leave them there for about 16 hours, and it's a lot of straining, but it's pretty cool.
Somebody asked about sun tea. I've never done that.
My mom used to do it. You know, it has a different flavor. I think it'd definitely be a good thing to look. We were just discussing on coming up with an iced tea lemonade, a sweet tea lemonade, but I know when I was a kid, my mom made sun tea all the time in Pennsylvania. You know, she just put the bags out in a big old type gallon pickle jar with the tea bags in them and sit them on the sun porch for, you know, all afternoon, and then it'd make tea. So.
Wow. Oh, we have... Aloha, I'm Lamar. I'm making fruit relishes. Is Matt making this for his Hawaiian dogs?
Fruit relish?
Yeah.
That's not a bad idea.
I'd love to hear more
about
that.
Sounds like a good idea, yeah. I mean,
yeah.
That's what the whole interchange of experience is about. I hadn't thought about it. That's a pretty good idea, though.
It says, Dorothy says, you don't even need sunshine to make sun tea. It is not bitter like brewed tea can be. Great tip. I've never done it. I know my wife has done sun tea, but I've never done it. You know, myself or for the business. I rarely drink tea. I'm a Diet Pepsi all the time, or bourbon, coffee. Okay, I need to figure out something real quick. Can you stay on, Matt?
We
other people and questions and stuff.
Absolutely.
Joe Kane has his hand raised, and I assume it means that he's got a wants to come on live. I'm going to try to unmute him. Joe, if you don't want to talk, just ignore us, and I'll mute it back. But I'm going to unmute you real quick. All right, Joe, can you hear us? Don't know. I'm not getting anything. Anyway, I'll mute it back, and then I'm going to take that one off. Let's see. He's still here. I just took his hand down. Because when it raises hand, it means that they want to talk, apparently. That's what I understand. And let me do something real quick. Can you, Matt, can you, you've done coffee, hot coffees, though, right?
Yeah, we do. I mean, I've done everything from an actual brew station on a camp stove type thing off of the small burners to just taking a Keurig out if it's an event. I mean, to be honest, that's pretty the easiest way to do hot coffee, unless you have a good bun set up or something like that. You know, I've told people, I think I mentioned him before, but Pedal Java here, he's a coffee cart that he pulls by a bike. But he built his own cart, and he has a little brewer on there that's powered by the 1 pound propane tanks, basically filtered up through his thing. So, I mean, there's a lot of ways you can rig it on your cart or anything else, I guess. You could use the camp stove on your grill, I guess, bringing it up. But I mainly use Keurig, but I want to go to cold brew. But it depends on your event. You know, if you have electrical outlets available, the speed of it, you know, how busy are you actually going to be? Because, you know, Keurigs are great for instant coffee and everything, but the expense is pretty high up there, too. You're looking around 53 cents per unit, whereas, of course, brewing is a little cheaper.
You know. I would love to also find out about this fruit stuff that he was talking about.
I've got a million ideas running through my head now. I'm like, man, I should just make that regularly. He's right. You know, make pineapple with a little cilantro, maybe throw in some type of jelly into it to make it thicken up. I got this watermelon jelly the other day that makes the best PB&J I've ever tried in my life.
somebody said that Sam's Club has the Arizona teas for 50 cent right now. In the big cans, 50 cent each. The Arizona iced, you know, sweet teas. So if you want to offer those, that's just something else to offer. It's great. That's a good tip. Okay, Joe said I do not have a mic. That's okay, Joe. It just showed you wanting to ask a question live, and so that's why I was unmuting you. Don't worry about it. It's happened before. Plus, I could be doing something wrong on my end. Okay, Dave Myers is the one that told us that. For whatever reason, we've got several people showing up just as friend. It just says friend on their name. And so one of them's Cassie, one of them's Dave Myers. So it doesn't tell me who's who, but Dave did say give us that information just now about the sweet teas. Thank you, Dave. Jalapeno peach jam. Outstanding on anything. I would eat it on dirt. It's so good. I have to try it on a dog. That's from Wendy.
It sounds good. I had a jalapeno jam. There was a lady next to me at the last event, that block party I did with Lemonade, and she sold all types of jams. She sold that watermelon one. She had a jalapeno, and they were all really good. But I guess jam could be a good thing. I've never tried it on a dog yet. So
I had the first time ever. Now, I love anything spicy, like beyond crazy spicy. I love spices, and I like heat. I don't want it so hot that I can't taste it, but I've gotten where I like it hotter and hotter and hotter. Well, I tried for the first time ever. My daughter was in with her fiance from Oregon, and she brought me pepper jam, like a jalapeno pepper jam. Had never seen it, never tried it. I put it on everything. She brought me a little jar of it, and I ate every bit of it like that. Within 2 days, it was gone. I was putting it on everything. So maybe that's what this jalapeno peach jam is kind of like.
Oktoberfest is coming up, officially on the 16th. So that's a reminder to everyone. Reach out to your bars, see if they want to do an event. The official kickoff date is... Well, to do it officially, like, I may be doing an event at 5:30 a.m. at my local Beard and Beer Market for the kickoff, which the 5:30 matches in Germany when they're going to officially untap the kegs in Oktoberfest.
Right.
So I may be doing a German breakfast style over there. But check with your local bars and such, because it's very easy to get and organize an Oktoberfest event. You know, make a special sauerkraut. Make a currywurst. That's what I'm going to be launching this week, is currywurst, which is, basically you make a German curry, which is kind of like a balsamic vinegar. You take red vinegar, sugar, a couple, tomatoes, and it's a real good sauce. You slice up the sausages and put them in it, reduce it, and it's amazing. It's like a good street food in Germany. And I'm going to test that out here with some hash browns. Usually you put French fries, but I can do grilled hash browns. So I'm going to make it a little different. But
wow.
That's a tip for September, because everyone thinks October, but really most of Oktoberfest is in September.
Yeah.
So check it out, see if you can organize a night at your local bar, get the word out there. Go all out for brats, do different, brats cooked in different beers, other things like that. I know it worked real well last year for me, and I've already got a couple Oktoberfest events lined up. Like I said, one at 5:30 in the morning. So,
wow. The Wendy just asked about breakfast on a cart, and she needed more information. I want to tell you this, Wendy. We talked about this this week on Facebook. I've been doing these almost daily videos on Facebook, answering people's questions, getting into more information, but staying kind of on topic. So I'll pick something that somebody's asked or several people have asked that are similar, same questions, and cover that. And we've been doing that, and Heather has even been taking some of the stuff, and we'll write it out, and I'll create some ebooks for you. And Heather's been getting those on the blog and stuff and putting those out. Those ebooks are only available for just a few days, and then they go into our Street Food Pro Vendors United group, where you can access them there if you're a member. Otherwise, you can't get them. But you can get them if you're following us on Facebook. So you may want to go back and check this past week some of the videos. We did something on breakfast, but I want to go ahead and answer this because breakfast is fun. Had a gentleman that was struggling in the business. He was struggling, let me take that back. He wasn't really struggling. He was doing pretty good, but he wasn't doing like great. Okay, then. And he called in a few times, telling us how he was doing and all that. And then he showed up early to the job one time, and somebody came up to him and said, "Hey, do you have coffee?" And he was like, "Nope, never thought about that." And so he got him one of those AirPods, and it took off from there. I'm going to make a long story short, but he really kicked butt. And now he just does breakfast. And then we've had several vendors, literally hundreds of vendors, have gone from doing lunch events to breakfast events. They just show up at breakfast time in front of a courthouse or in front of something where a lot of traffic is, a lot of people are, and they're doing breakfast stuff. People are doing bagels. People are doing, because bagels are so good in a steamer. They'll get hot and stay moist. They're delicious. And some people are doing breakfast type dogs, like bacon cheddar dogs. Bacon, and I'm saying actually buying the dog, the brat, maple cheddar, maple bacon brats. You can buy that stuff, and they're selling them. And so that may be something to do. But coffee is a great way to start. I wouldn't say go out there and spend $5,000 preparing and planning around a breakfast cart. What I would do is try it. Just try it with a few items, and then keep adding to it. And what will end up happening is you'll stumble on a couple things that are big hits, and you'll go, oh, not this one, but this one. And the AirPods are wonderful. If you don't know what those are, we gave AirPods away recently. You know, a couple months ago, I think we gave them away. And I set them with the rack and everything. They're fantastic for doing coffee because they'll keep it hot forever without heat being given to it. Hopefully that answers your question. But find that video I did on Facebook this week. That gives a lot more detail on that, Wendy. Hope that helps you. How can you have a simple hot dog menu or sausage on an ice cream truck that is constantly moving? How can you have a simple hot dog menu or sausage on an ice cream truck that's constantly moving? A little more difficult, but not the end of the world. We have some vendors that are constantly moving. You know, they go from one job site to the next, and they just pull up, stop, and, you know, maybe they're 10, 15 minutes, and they pre-wrap their dogs. So in between stops, they will pre-wrap a bunch of dogs. And I think I know who this is. I think this is Cassie talking about she already has a food truck, but she's just been doing snacks and ice cream stuff. And, yes, you could definitely keep it in a warmer. You could keep dogs pre-wrapped up. Now, they're not going to be as good as a freshly dog, but I promise you, use aluminum foil and wrap those suckers up good and don't oversteam them. You'll end up with a nice, good tasting dog that you can hand out to people. I know some vendors doing that with hamburgers. I know some vendors doing that with chili cheesesteaks. It's definitely something you could do.
I was talking to a local food truck, and I was looking at his fryer and how he keeps his oil in, and he built this thing, and I'm going to attempt to do it. And if I put it, I'll put up pictures. I know I'll put it up in the one group, but I may put it up on the main Facebook page too. But I've been looking in how to move quickly to different locations, because we have, you know, when you have situations where you have 2 miles worth of car dealerships and a bunch of mechanics, everything like that. So I had an idea there. But the problem is basically what you're going to face in an ice cream truck. How do you keep the water from splashing around to keep a hot, fresh product? Basically, this one food truck uses basically a push piece of metal that he fashioned and cut, and it basically creates a suction to where, as he pushes it down, it creates a seal. And I'm trying to do that with the third pans and make a product to do that. To where I can just pretty much strap my pans down and move, because that's one thing we've always said. Well, the only way to, you know, hey, don't, you know, dump your water out because it's going to make a mess. But I'm trying to make something that'll basically keep the water in completely and seal using pressure, and then basically release as you pull it back up. Same thing they use for certain Tupperware and such like that.
I've seen those push lids before. I've never seen it for a steam pan, but I would imagine that you could create something like that.
I mean, that would be the ideal solution for her question, because then she could keep the water hot, move to the next place. And, I mean, if you're an ice cream truck with hot dogs, that'd be a pretty killer combo, I think. Yeah. But, yeah, I agree. I mean, a fresh hot dog is always going to win you repeat business versus a wrap dog or anything like that. You know, I can imagine if you know, every time I was at the park on Tuesday, the ice cream truck pulled up and they had a fresh hot dog I could get too, I'd be there. But
Dave just asked if anybody has tried Big Mac sauce on a dog. Big Mac sauce, isn't that just Thousand Island?
It's Thousand Island. So, yeah, I have with my Reuben dog, and, you know, a lot of people have a Reuben dog. You know, I use Boar's Head corned beef, a sauerkraut, grill that on my grill. And then, you know, when it's about done, I put the Swiss cheese on it. And before I put that onto the dog, I put Thousand Island on the dog. Then I put all that meat and cheese and everything on it, and then I put the Coke onions on top and a little more Thousand Island. So, I mean, there's a lot of ways you could use it. I mean, you know, you can make BLT dogs. I'm sure you can make a Big Mac dog. So.
Yeah.
So.
I mean, it seemed fair to me. I like that Big Mac sauce, but from what I understand, they just have a little more sugar in theirs, and it gives it a little bit of twang and sweet, a little sweeter than a normal Thousand Island, you know, like Kraft. Okay, Wendy says thank you. Let's see. How do I vend the city when they don't allow vending? Well, if you go to learnhotdogs.com and on the right-hand side there is a search box and you type in the word justice, you're going to pull up every rant I've had on this, and it'll make
you feel... I was about to say, is it midnight yet? We finished that question. So.
Yeah, that is a common question, though. Still, every day I get it. Every day. Because somebody is calling from a city that has told them they've called in. So there's two things I want you to do, John. Two things. First, get proof that they say that you are not allowed in. Because I've had this happen multiple times, and even live on this show. One time I recorded our conversation with a lady, and we called her city, and the city, I got the same lady she did, and the lady told me, yeah, we don't allow vendors. And I said, can you give me a copy of that code? And she goes, well, what do you mean code? I said, well, y'all have to have a code that says that you're going to discriminate against me, so can I have a copy of that, because I want to pass it on to the lawyers. Well, she didn't even have a code. She had just heard that, and she was just passing it along. So vendors are getting discouraged, thinking, oh, we can't vend because they have a code or they don't allow it. No, they can't restrict vendors, period. Federal law, period. It's been to federal court already. They can't restrict you, period. So look up justice. That'll solve it. But the second thing I want you to do, before you look up justice, go to learnhotdogs.com/liar, L-I-A-R, and it talks about how to get proof before. Sometimes you don't even have to deal with anything else once you prove that they don't even have a code. Most of them don't even have a code. It's just BS. Like somebody heard it from somebody else, and you know that circle thing you played when you were a kid in school, and they start a story, and by the time it gets to the end, it's something else. And so you have this nitwit at the city hall or county government who goes, oh, we don't allow this or we don't allow that, and they don't even know. They don't even know the code exists. So that's what I would do, John. I hope that helps. Oh, roller heaters work good in a truck, David Legue says. I don't like roller heaters, but in your situation, Cassie, when you're on a truck and it's moving, roller heaters may be a good option for you, because roller heaters typically is for long term. It's slow cooking. Now, you can turn up the dial, heat them quicker, but you aren't going to have yours on there long enough for them to get crappy. So it may work great for you. It's kind of like grilling them but constantly rolling them at the same time. So I think that may be a good option for you. And plus, roller heaters are pretty inexpensive, and you wouldn't have to deal with the water issue toting it around.
There's steamer machines too.
There's instant steamers.
You know, that could work too. So.
Yep. Thanks for the suggestion, though, David. That was nice of you. Yeah, microwave works, but microwave, unless you get a really, really good microwave, my microwave at my house, I've threatened a sledgehammer at it several times, because I can put in butter. Like I do a lot of baking, and I'll put in butter and because I'm supposed to use softened butter, and I forgot to lay it out or whatever for my softened butter. You put it in there for 3 seconds, nothing. 7 seconds, and you've got it, boils it to a crisp, and 4, 5, and 6 seconds does nothing. So it's like has its own mind. Sometimes I can put it in there for 20, nothing happens, and put it in there for 4, and I've melted the plastic around it. So a microwave may work for a dog, but you'd want a good microwave, and then, you know, and a good source of power to it, a good inverter. Okay, my truck and only two other trucks in my town. That's freaking awesome. Cassie, I assume that's you. My truck and only two other trucks in your town. You're going to kick butt either way. You already have a name. You already have a retail store as well. You're not going to have a problem. You start adding some other stuff, and there's more than just that. You can add easier stuff. You can do hot pretzels with jalapenos and cheese on them and stuff that we've done. Done it. Jason and I did the pretzel thing. I did it several times on my cart to show people how that's done, and it's good money. So there's lots of different ideas for what you can do off that cart. You already have the truck. You already have the restaurant, the commissary. You're good to go. I'd add something right now, just so you all know. Cassie just does right now sweets and treats, basically ice cream and treats. And so she's thinking about branching into hot dogs or something, and she has the perfect setup for it already. She's perfect. She's already got customers. Okay, Burger King has a Whopper dog now. Oh yeah, I saw that. I saw the Whopper dog, Greg. Let's see. I'm going through these questions. When a mobile truck, blah, blah, blah. Yep, steam table really low on water to reduce splash. Yeah, Dave says we had have a mobile truck. We simply kept steam table really super low on water level. That works great. When I'm on my cart and I'm not moving, I keep my water level low because I like to flash steam. I like rapid steaming. And it heats quick, and it steams fast and super hot because it's boiling at 900 degrees at one time, quick. And that way I can put stuff in there quick and get it out quick. So that's a great idea for Cassie, too, is to keep your steamer low on water. Jump in here anytime you want, Matt. I'm just going through these questions a little as I go. Soften butter put on a saucer with glass over it helps soften fast. I do that when I think about it. I do. I just sometimes I'm caught in that thing, and I was mostly complaining about the fact that my microwave has a mind of its own. It'll melt the glass underneath the bowl before it'll melt the butter sometimes. It's like you pick up the bowl and it's so hot you can't touch it and the butter's still cold. Just the stupidest cheap microwave. But great suggestion. I do that. I put the lid over it. Let's see, is there a source for concession items cheap, three compartment sink, pretzel warmer, anything else? Cheap's a tricky one. You can find them, and sometimes you'll find, here's where I'll help you. A three compartment sink, if it's full size, big, you could probably make it. You could probably make it, okay, without a lot less money. Okay, we show how we make them for the Build-A-Cart course. So you could make it. But if you go to if you live near or in a big city, they will have a used restaurant supply. Matt's got one near him, okay, mm-hmm. over in Knoxville. And you can sometimes find unbelievable deals, unbelievable. And so that may be the first thing you should look at, but also Google used restaurant equipment, because you'll find people online already doing it. They go into a restaurant that's closing up, buy everything, and they get it dirt cheap, pennies on the dollar, and then they sell it for, you know, eight times that, but it's still less than you'd pay retail. So it's a good opportunity for you to save money and buy some of that stuff that you need, pretzel warmers, anything like that.
Yeah, and there's a couple groups on Facebook too to keep track of. I watch just for deals in case. Let me see here. What are they called? Concession Trailers and Equipment group on Facebook. Restaurant Equipment Food Truck. But basically, that's just where people sell used equipment, used food trucks, used, you know. Oh, somebody just put a pizza trailer on there. I love those things. I mean, there's used equipment all over. I mean, if you're willing to drive or willing to ship it, I mean, you can probably get a pretty good deal on it. So
yeah, check on eBay too. I wanted one of these new umbrellas with the lights in it that's solar.
I went to a party the other day and someone had it on their porch and I was like, dude, I'm going to steal that and put it on my cart.
I just got one, $59 on eBay, 10 foot.
Oh, jeez.
Swivel top, you know, it twists the crank and it's metal. It's a nice umbrella for $59. Okay, if you want fresh hot coffee, I know people that use the Keurig coffee maker. I've seen some people do the Keurigs. I like the AirPods because there's nothing to do. No, I don't have to carry water with me. You just pour everything in there, hot, fresh coffee, and it stays tasting. This 2 hours later, it tastes the same.
And the price is, like I said, Keurig, I've done it, but your price is around 50 cents just for a Keurig pod in general. Right. So.
Yeah, and now they have those the pods you can open up and put your own coffee in, but then it's just another thing you got to do. Mm-hmm. He says used places will also trade stuff, so that's a good suggestion to trade with them if you have something that they want and you can do a trade. Yes, I have tried the Member's Mark B Franks from Sam's Club. Somebody asked, Mickey asked if I had tried those Maker's Mark or Member's Mark B Franks from Sam's Club. If they took the place of the, he put Daily Shift, but it was actually the, what's the ones?
Baker's and Chef. Yeah.
And I can't tell the difference. I still, you know, I have my favorites, yeah, that's a good dog.
The meat tastes great. To me, the only thing I don't like about them is they're really long and thin, but they do, they last up in the water. But you got to get a bun that looks right with them. That's the only problem I have with them. But your price is great.
Buns look good with them because they don't go as deep.
Yeah, and that's what I mean. Because usually I'll use like the dogs for my quarter pound, so I can't use the same bun, so because they're just way too big for those dogs. Right. So,
hey, Zebulon asks, do we have any vendors that are using gluten-free buns?
I use them occasionally. I mean, it's, you know. What I do for gluten-free, and here's what I'm going to tell you about gluten-free. The problem is there's not a lot of preservatives for them. So when I first started out, I kept vegan buns and I kept gluten-free buns, and, you know, a classic case of just trying to do too much. The problem with them is the preservatives are not either there or not the same strength as regular buns, and you can buy them and they've literally already got mold on them. So they don't last very long and they're very expensive. What I offer for both vegan, now I keep vegan products, and gluten-free, now most of your hot dogs are already gluten-free, is a deconstructed dog, and I have a picture, and I'll probably put it up on my Facebook. The other night I made one for my sister-in-law, because she can't eat bread, because she's on a ketogenic diet, and no low sugars and such like that. But I call it deconstructed because you slice it up, you throw some cheese or some chili, onions, and you kind of just make a hot dog stir fry on the grill and put it in your boat or something. Make it look pretty with some sauces, put some extra cheese on the top of it, garnish it, you know, if you carry anything like a pickle or something, make it look pretty. But that's a good way to give a gluten-free and a true vegan option without carrying those products. If it's really important to you or you have just a ton of people that are your, you know, that are going to buy, I mean, you know, for six of those buns, you're talking about paying generally $4 to $6. I mean, you know, your profit margins are in the tank at that point anyway, especially if you have waste. But, you know, that's one option for gluten-free people.
That's great. Let me tell something about gluten-free just so y'all know, and you can look this up, and if you disagree with me, send me science-based facts, or otherwise I won't read it. But gluten is naturally found in wheats and grains. Gluten is what gives it that sponginess. To take that gluten out is what Matt was just talking about. The process to remove gluten, a natural occurring thing in our grains, gets rid of some of its natural properties to preserve it. Okay? Not that it'd preserve forever, but wheat will last a long time, just dry wheat. Okay? In a cool, dry, you know, bag. So it's really, really good stuff. and it makes the bread nicer. But there's people, the only people that don't need gluten are people who have celiac disease, okay, which is an intestinal thing, but it's a disease. And those people really get into a lot of pain, really, but you're talking less than 2% of the population. But because marketers are so good at what they do, they created something new for us to be afraid of, glutens. And so they've pushed the heck out of this. And people are going, oh, I can't eat gluten, I can't eat gluten. Do you have celiac disease? Never heard of it. Well, then you can eat gluten because it doesn't affect you at all. And so that's my two cents on gluten. I do want to tell you something funny. You just talked about that deconstructed dog. My daughter was making a dog the other day, Matt, and she goes, she says, I said, what are you making? Because it was a mess on the plate. And she goes, well, I'm doing a decomposed hot dog. And I said, a what? And she goes, a decomposed dog, Dad. I saw it on Pinterest or something, Instagram or something. And I said, I wouldn't eat that because that's gross. And she goes, no, it's really good. It's the same stuff that goes in a normal dog. And I said, are you meaning something totally different? Because decomposed is probably not what you want. Anyway, we've got some stuff to give away. We've only got a few more minutes left, and let me make sure, have you ever tried soft taco shells as a wrap on a dog? Absolutely, and I made some and did a video for it and posted it on the blog and on Facebook recently, pretty recently, right, Matt?
Yeah, and if you do corn, now that brings up something else. My dad actually said this to me. He said, well, if you just do corn tortillas or you keep them on the cart, then you can do they're gluten-free.
Yeah.
Corn tortillas, and then you can make or if people don't like a lot of bread. So, you did it with the burrito. It was awesome.
Gluten-free. Oh, it's water. Gluten-free. Well, great.
That'll be $3 extra.
Yeah, $3 extra for your gluten-free water. Or this diet water. Okay, waiting on the health, but I have done a couple of, I have used a green leaf lettuce instead of a bun. Everyone seems to love it. Freaking awesome. Haven't thought of that. I remember when, I think it was Hardee's came out with the low-calorie hamburger, and they wrapped the hamburger in lettuce instead of bun. And I thought that was brilliant, and I ate a lot of them just because it was cool, not because I didn't like bread. I'd ask for my bread on the side and eat it later. It was cool eating it out of lettuce. I like the fact of wrapping a hot dog with lettuce. That's a lettuce-wrapped dog. It's cool as crap. I'd love to see a picture if you do this, Sergio. That's cool as crap. Sergio just said that.
Yeah, maybe I'll head back to my P.F. Chang Peiwei days and do a video on how to make lettuce wraps. Make the lettuce cups.
All right,
I made a lot of those in my day.
Yeah, I've had lettuce cups. Have you ever heard of a used Kent Bracelet? Okay, I'm going to post this up for everybody. I assume it's okay. It's this is from Truett. Shared this one. This is a link to the Kent Franks and Sausages, and it's their PDF catalog. If anybody looking for something unique or want to try a new dog, John, Yankee Dogs, do you like Sabret? I don't know. Sabret, I like Sabret. But I wouldn't do Sabret unless I was in a couple of states. If I was in South Florida, and I think the other one is upstate New York, I think, is another Sabret hot dog.
New Jersey, too, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, people in Tennessee don't even have any idea, unless they're from there, have no idea what they are, so.
Mike just reminded us that Corey does the hot dog burrito, you know, and he even does a panini press type one too, where he presses the burrito.
Yeah, I think he takes the quarter pounder and cuts it in half, and then he's got a video on there, I think, of him making it too. So
he does. He does. Let's see. What are the top 10 beef dogs?
Corey is O Doggies, for anyone who doesn't know who Corey is. O Doggies on Facebook.
O Doggies, yep. What are the top 10 beef dogs?
Anything but bar S.
Yeah, anything but bar S. There is no top 10, and I do tell you on my free training how to determine what dog is best to use for your area. Somebody said, what kind of dog for Mississippi? Probably armadillo. I'm just teasing. The Mississippi, you could go with, if it was me, I'd just stay with Oscar Mayer All Beef Franks, or go to Sam's and get that. It's not the Bakers and Chefs anymore, but their brand, which I was told is made by Nathan's, and you get the all beef one and you can't lose. There's other brands. There's Nathan's. There's all kinds. Somebody says Sabret is distributed by Marathon in New Jersey. Has anyone tried replacing fish with a hot dog in a sushi roll? No, but it sounds delicious. I could do that. That's a good idea. I like these ideas tonight, Matt.
Well, thank you. Thank you for the new hot dog idea. I just have to tell my wife to get working on that. So.
Yeah, and Cassie's the one in Mississippi that I was making fun of with the armadillos. Or you can substitute pots and dogs, Cassie. And let's see. Okay, so here's the deal. I got to go, but I'm going to give some stuff away. So if you ask any more questions, Heather did come in here, even though she was supposed to be at a birthday party, and I told her not to come in here. She did anyway, and she's been answering questions and helping people out. If you have a question that we miss, I may just do it tomorrow on the show. I will be doing a live thing tomorrow on Facebook, but we have some free stuff to give away. First, you can't even see who all's here, can you, Matt?
No.
Hopefully Heather's still listening. Heather, if you can hear me, can you pick a winner of the shirt real quick out of the list of people that are still here? She can see who's here. I can't pull up the screen right now. If not, I'm going to have to just go to the question section and pull somebody that recently asked a question. Greg said she's still here. See, I can't see everybody that's here. We have a full house, though. Okay, so we're going to give away a shirt. I'm going to wait on Heather, but let me tell you this. Oh, there's Heather. Heather, can you pick somebody with your little that random thing you used the other day? We gave away some stuff Friday during the live show Friday on Facebook, and we gave away some chip clips. Winner is Jerry Ray. Jerry Ray, you win. The t-shirt, and if you will email or just message, just do this, email ben@learnhotdogs.com, ben@learnhotdogs.com, your name, address, and a phone number. I will get that out in the mail to you immediately, and hopefully the fourth time's the charm, and we'll actually get this shirt to someone that will wear it. It's an extra large. I don't have other sizes. Hope you love it. I think it's sexy. I think you'll look good in it. We want to see pictures. Next, the other thing I promised everybody that stayed, I was going to give away some stuff, two free ebooks tonight. You can take them or leave them. You can just go to this page and look at them. All you do is just, say you want it. That's it. The page, and I think Heather's going to post up the page to everybody, but it is learnhotdogs.com/dogs, D-O-G-S. That page will be gone tomorrow about noon. Okay. The extra bonus on top of that is, if you don't know anything about the Street Food Protein, this hat that I'm wearing right now, and Vendors United, it is the most of the most. If you want to learn the most of the most, but you want to try it out before you buy it kind of thing, you want to see what it's like and get full access, I'm giving full access. Full access, it's a 10-day full access pass. You can download stuff. You can buy stuff at half price. You can do all kinds of stuff in there. And all you do is go to learnhotdogs.com/dogs, okay, and get the ebooks or don't get the ebooks, but the next page will give you your 10-day free pass, okay? And in there, we're giving away a cart in 87 days, folks. 87 days, we're giving away a cart on December 1st and live right here. Free hot dog cart. That's going to happen. You'll see that in the members area too, because that's where we're giving it away. And I think, if you were here For the beginning of the show, before the pre-show show, I am giving away a free pro pack. You're going, what the heck? Is he giving away all the stuff? I'm giving away a free pro pack, okay, to somebody who leaves a review on our Facebook page. There's a review section. You put in a star amount and a review. Don't leave a review if you don't know who we are or don't have done business with us or anything. I want real reviews. You know what I'm saying? But somebody who, we're going to pick one person who's going to get a whole pro pack mailed to them, shipped to them free. That's it. It is past 10, and I got to go because I have my wife kill me is the bottom line. Let's wrap it up. Matt, I want to thank you. I want to tell everybody follow Matt on Facebook. Thanks to everybody that contributed and helped tonight, Greg and Mike and Jerry and Cassie and all the great people that came in tonight and helped out. We had a full house. Thank you, and I'll see you tomorrow live on Facebook, probably about 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. I love you guys. We'll see you later.
Take care, everybody.